tells me I'm entering the runway. This thing likes to climb. I want to see that worm up there.
Holy one.
There's number one, we'll just go follow that up the bell plane.
Sure.
We want to sit at about 3,000 feet, right?
Where do you see it?
Right here, that's our altitude.
Oh, what are we at now?
3,100. Oh, I really actually need to get down a little bit. This thing's still trying to climb.
Put time up?
Yeah, oh, time up 1:52, so 1352. Oh, and actually going west, we should be at about 3,500 feet.
I took 2 weeks vacation for the honeymoon. A couple tickets all inclusive down in Cancun. I couldn't get my money back, so I'm in seat 7A. I'm getting drunk on a plane. I bet the fella on the aisle thought I was crazy, 'cause I taped your picture to the seat back right beside me. Now I've got empty mini bottles filling both our trays. I'm getting drunk on a plane. Buying drinks for everybody but the pilot, it's a party. Got this 737 rocking like a G6. This is some sexy leaning, pouring coke and whiskey. Told her about my condition, got a little mile high flight attention. It's Mardi Gras up in the clouds. I'm up so high, may never come down. I'll try anything to drown out the pain. They all know why I'm getting drunk on a plane.
Reach on a tower, Susan Bobble's training left for final.
X-ray Zulu Bravo, roger. The Satabria short final now.
X-ray Zulu Bravo. You're supposed to tell me that I could turn. Oh, now it's charging. I just have to turn my brightness down. It was killing it, I guess. Okay, so all this shit's way off because we're way the fuck out to launch, right?
Yep.
So I'm gonna get over here because I was waiting for him to let me know. So I can be on final, but I don't have clearance to land yet, right? So he was short final, so he's in front of me. But sometimes these planes are so small, like you just can't see each other.
And they're white.
Yeah. So now we're lined up. We're low, so I'd have to get up high to chase that other needle, right?
Yeah.
Then we want to get down, so now we're good.
Oh. Sierra Echo Tower, exit Mike, call me on ground 21-9.
0-0, go ahead, signal.
Tower, perfect approach.
21-9.
He's already taxied off there too. We're gonna slow down to about 90 airspeed. I keep the nose up. Now we're high, right? So I gotta get down.
Sierra Sierra Echo ground taxi Bravo to the hangar line. X-ray Zulu Bravo Tower, wind 14010, clear to land runway 13.
X-ray Zulu Bravo, clear to land runway 13, thanks. And you use the trim wheel because it'll help you with the rear elevator so you don't have to put so much pressure on this, right? I'll get some rudder in there, keep us straight. Now I'm too high, right? I'm gonna cut the engines at idle right now. Oh, we're too high on this approach still. Oh, I gotta get down. On it. I'm even kind of fast for this one too, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull up here. We'll burn off some speed. We want to sit at about 8. And we're idle again.
1 Alpha Juliet Tower, line up runway 13.
Line up 13, 1 Alpha Juliet.
We're just gonna go down to Kilo here and I'll taxi off there. Cool, eh?
That was pretty cool.
X-ray Zulu Bravo Tower, exit Mike, ground 21-9.
X-ray Zulu Bravo, exit or Kilo 121-9, thanks.
X-ray Zulu Bravo, Mike exit there for you.
X-ray Zulu Bravo, Mike, thanks. What did I say? I said Kilo, didn't I?
Yeah.
So when you land with this thing, then what it'll do is it'll actually bring up what shows me on here now. So on the chart there, I can see exactly where I am, right? So if you're in a big airport, you can go and look at that in advance, and it'll show you where you are and everything. And
pretty cool.
Yeah, it's like, I should have this plugged in on a two-hour flight. It almost killed it.
1 Alpha Juliet Tower, Winnipeg Center, 120.1.
Did he say monitor ground? Or contact ground? Remember? I didn't catch that.
I don't know.
Okay, so time down is going to be 3:36. Regina ground, X-ray Zulu Bravo's taxi to the hangar line.
X-ray Zulu Bravo ground taxi to the hangar line.
Oh, look at the jet taking off. Look out your window. Yeah. No. Oh. Oh, here, I'll turn. When we turn, you'll see him. Look, he's already up. He's fucking gone. See him?
Yeah, I see him when we're landing. He's on the left-hand side.
Got the 336 on there?
336.
Awesome. So then you do your checklist, right? So pre-landing, so we can turn that off, go back to that fuel, and actually you're not supposed to land with that fuel on like that either, but that's okay. The thing is you can't go off of those either, right? They're not, those fuel tanks aren't very accurate. You gotta know how much fuel you have and what your burn's gonna be. And this plane burns, like say around 10 gallons per hour, right? So we only needed half a tank, really. So maybe it is hard on fuel thing.
I think it is, buddy. Tell you the truth.
You pumped a quarter of that.
Quarter of the reserve is coming back.
That's 5 gallons, yeah.
Yeah.
Huh. Yeah, I've been back from Port Capel's like a quarter of our trip, which is 5 gallons. That's not too bad. Now, where does he want me to park this thing? I'll just go beside this guy. And I gotta get all this shit out of here.